All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Robert Bose. He is the CEO of Sintana Energy. And Robert, it's good to see you again. How are you?
Very well, thanks, Steve. Very well. Nice to see you again as well. Thank you for having me back.
Yeah, so a couple of pretty significant pieces of news out from the company. We'll talk about both those in a second. It all has to do with Mopane-1X and others as well. And there's sort of a consortium, Robert. Maybe you can kind of explain to us how all this is working right now with these wells.
Sure, absolutely. So, you know, your audience may recall that in 2022, we completed a transaction wherein we acquired a minority interest in a holding company. That holding company, in turn, has various subsidiaries that own interests in various licenses. Mopane-1X is in one of those licenses. It is operated by the Portuguese energy company, Galp Energia. Our partners there are as well, the National Oil Company of Namibia called NAMCOR. So there's three parties in that license, of which we are indirectly one. As well, you know, subsidiaries include our interest in licenses that are variously operated by Chevron and potentially by Woodside. And so the discovery, as I mentioned, occurred in the Mopane prospect, which sits in PEL 83, which is operated by Galp Energy of Portugal.
Yeah, so this is now the second significant light oil discovery at Mopane. So tell me a little bit about you know, these last two and what this means.
Well, it's just fantastic news, Steve, you know, for Namibia, for the basin, for our partners and for us specifically. You know, this Mopane-1X location was the first well that was drilled on a block besides those that were drilled on blocks by Shell and Total. So again, the audience may recall over the past 18 months, Shell and Total have drilled something on the order of 12 wells. They found approximately 11 billion barrels of original oil in place and something like 9 TCF of gas. But most of the activity had been entirely centered on their two blocks from a drilling perspective. So this was the first drilling campaign beyond that. And we were, you know, just thrilled to be a part of it. And as you say, it's been just an amazing start to the year. We announced an initial light oil discovery on January the 10th. And then on January 26th, we were able to announce a second light oil discovery in a different horizon. So, you know, this, I think, does a few things. It continues to demonstrate the sheer scale of the Orange Basin. The Mopane prospect contains up to 10 billion barrels of original oil in place itself. Secondly, it confirms kind of the extension of some of the discoveries on the Shell and Total blocks northward to some of our other blocks. And, you know, as I said, we are an indirect participant in these outcomes. So it's just a absolutely fantastic bit of progress for Sintana and, you know, hopefully just the start of more ahead.
Absolutely. Now, I understand there's going to be some what they call a drill stem test. Can you sort of talk us through what sort of the next stages are here?
Sure. So now that operations have been completed at the 1X location where we've had the two discoveries, the rig will move to the 2X location where it will execute a drilling operation. Those drilling operations are contemplated to intersect the upper discovery that occurred at the 1X location as well as a deeper target. Upon completion of those drilling operations, the rig will return to the 1X location and execute something called the drill stem test, as you allude to. A drill stem test essentially measures the sort of commercial productivity of the reservoir. They actually flow the well. So we'll have a sense not only about, you know, the fact that there's kind of significant hydrocarbon volumes there, but the sort of extent of their flow. So that is a key test of the commerciality of these potential resources. And one of the interesting things about PEL 83 is it sits in materially shallow waters versus some of the developments, for example, on the Total block. It's in roughly 1,500 meters of water. And so from a commercialization perspective, if the flow rates work, this should be a world-class potential development opportunity in PEL 83.
Yeah. So is that sort of the message, Robert, you want shareholders and those that follow the company to understand that, you know, these are two in a row of starting work in 2024. It sounds like it's a pretty significant start to the year for your company.
Absolutely, Steve. I think, you know, prior to this, you know, we talked a lot about what was happening around us, which is good. Certainly, it's you want to be in the right neighborhood at the right time. And I certainly feel like we have been. But to be able to announce two light oil discoveries on one of just one of, you know, a handful of blocks that we have has just been, you know, a huge step forward from us. I think it's turned us from kind of a portfolio of as yet unknown options to the owner of an indirect interest in a world scale discovery with a bunch more options to boot. So it is a huge bit of progress for the company, and as I said, a real step forward not only for us but for Namibia and for the Orange Basin as well.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. Robert, thank you so much. Great to catch up with you, and we'll talk soon, okay?
It's great to see you again, Stephen. Thanks again for the time. Really appreciate it.
All right, Robert Bose, the CEO of Sintana Energy.